First of all, I offer my obeisances to my Gurudev Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj and Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj. And then, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj and all the assembled devotees. That So that when Mahaprabhu's big brother, he left after sannyas, then Mahaprabhu, he used to study in the school. Sachi Mata, in her mind, she was thinking, she did not speak to anyone else, but she said, she thought that he is not Advaita, he is Dvaita. Dvaita means he is dual, means who create differences between the two people. He is not Advaita. Advaita is non-dual. That he has taught such a lesson to my son that my son has left me. So she got separated from her son. So that is why he is Dvaita. Dvaita means separation into two. So she just thought it, she did not speak it to anyone else. So then Mahaprabhu said, Advaita Acharya is the Sakshat Acharya of the Bhakti. Then how her offenses would be destroyed, everyone asked. That she has to ask forgiveness. Then Sachi Mata asked forgiveness from Advaita Acharya. Then Advaita Acharya, Mahaprabhu became merciful to the Sachi Mata. So we all should be very, very careful that we should not do offenses to any devotee. So we should always be careful about the offenses. So many people are doing bhajan, but there is special instructions given to those who are doing bhajan that you should be careful from the Vaishnava aparadha, because this your bhajan will be destroyed if you are doing the offenses. Because it is not easy that everyone will get liberated and go to Bhagavad Dham. Because if everyone start going to the Bhagavad Dham, then this materialistic world would become empty. So always we have to do bhajan, and also be careful that we should not do offenses to a Vaishnava. So we have heard very nice transcendental character of Krishna Keshava Brahmachari. We should always hear devotee's life history, because Vaishnava's life is ati martya, beyond this materialistic world. And as soon as we hear their story, we get more and more curiosity of doing bhajan. Today is also another special day, Ekadashi Tithi. So we should also hear the glories of Ekadashi on the day of Ekadashi. Though we have heard it many times, but still, it is said in the Shastra, Anavriti Shabdat, means again and again here. So it is not going to happen just hearing once. So what should be done? Hear again and again. So the glories of Ekadashi one should hear again and again. Why? Because the nature of the conditioned soul is that he forgets. That today we have heard and after some time we forget it. So in the Shastra it is said again and again one should hear. So one may say that just by hearing once it is sufficient, but no, one has to hear it again and again on the day of Ekadashi. We should not eat five type of grains: gehum, wheat, dal, jaw, barley, rice, and also mustard. Sabu. Oh. So one should also not eat sabudana. Sabudana is also another type of grain. So in the Gaudiya Math, no one eats sabudana on the day of Ekadashi. Many other people eat. So five type of grains one should not eat. And because this five type of grains has the pap, the sins in it, even if the Mahaprasad comes in front of you, which has been offered to the Lord, the rice or the dal comes in front of you, then on the day of Ekadashi one should not eat it. Swayam Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he was staying in Jagannath Puri, the Pandas of Jagannath Dev, they thought the people of the Gaudiya Math do not accept the Mahaprasad on the day of Ekadashi. So if the Mahaprabhu would eat, then everyone would start eating. So, and many people in the Jagannath says that while you are staying in the Jagannath Puri, you should not keep the Ekadashi fast. And even they have hanged Ekadashi in the opposite direction in the temple. But Mahaprabhu said no. In the Shastra it is written that one should always follow Ekadashi. And who is Jagannath Dev? He is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Swami Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that on the day of Ekadashi, one should never accept Mahaprasad. Then the Pandas, they brought a big plate of Jagannath Mahaprasad. They came to a place where Mahaprabhu was doing Nam Sankirtan with his devotees on Ekadashi. By seeing the Pandas, Mahaprabhu was so pleased. And Mahaprabhu was so pleased to see the Jagannath Prasad, considering it to be Sakshat Jagannath, and started glorifying the Mahaprasad. And Mahaprabhu said that it is written in the Shastra that as soon as you see Jagannath Prasad, that without any considerations of time, place or any circumstances, one should accept it. So Mahaprabhu said, the Pandas thought that, oh, Mahaprabhu has said like this, so he will surely eat today. But Mahaprabhu, when the plate has arrived of Mahaprasad, Mahaprabhu said that this Mahaprasad is Sakshat Jagannath Dev. So we should first offer prayers, Mahaprasad Govinda Naam Brahmani Vaishnavi. So he started doing Vandana. Then Mahaprabhu said that Mahaprasad is Jagannath Dev. We should do parikrama. Then Mahaprabhu along with the devotees, they started doing parikrama. Hari Harai Namah, Krishna Yadavai Namah. So for the whole night, Mahaprabhu, he was doing parikrama of the Mahaprasad. So then the morning came. So Mahaprabhu said to all the devotees that it's already morning. So we should all go to ocean to take bath. And after taking bath, they came back. Now it is the Paran time. Many people, they do Paran. They follow the fast, but they do not follow the Paran instructions. But in the Bhagavat, the character of Amrish Maharaj, the whole incident of Durvasa Rishi and Amrish Maharaj, the whole incident was because of the Paran time. So Mahaprabhu said the sun has risen and it is a time to open the fast now. So Mahaprabhu called all disciples and distributed that Jagannath Prasad to everyone. So in this way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Shachinandan Gaur Hari, Sakshat Jagannath Swarup, he gave this teaching to the whole world that on the day of Ekadashi one should never eat the grains. There is another story. If a person is near to death, he has got many diseases, he is on death bed and he cannot leave, he is not getting died but he is in a very bad condition. So it is written in the Shastra that if you have done Nirjala Ekadashi, so just give a very small part of that Ekadashi's results to that person who is about to die. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj used to speak this katha. He said that Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada's one disciple whose name was Bhakhanas Bhakti Gaurav, Bhakhanas Maharaj, he was a royal Pandit. In his previous life, he was a very big body and also very handsome. He was also a scholar of Sanskrit. Before coming to Prabhupada, in his previous life, he took birth in the Brahman family. What he did one time, he went to a house of a grihastha and was doing some havan puja, some Brahman activities. So what they did, so Vaikhanas Maharaj, he went there. So I forgot the name of that place. So after doing all the activities, religious activities in their house, so he received a lot of dakshina, like the clothes, fruits. So many type of things he received in dakshina. So he was coming back, he rented out a car and he was coming back. When he was coming back to his house, on the way there was cloud in the sky and there was a lot of rain, and even there were ice balls falling from the sky. So in the midnight, like it was already evening, late night, and it was air was flowing, and he thought that what should I do now? I am in like in middle of a very big storm. So he asked someone that, is there any place to stay here so that I can spend my one night? So that person, a shopkeeper, he said that in this village there is a house which is empty, a two-floor building which is empty, you can stay there. So he went there and he made the arrangement to sleep. So that house was all empty, no one was there. So for many years there were no one in the house. So he cleaned the place and he made the arrangements to sleep. In the midnight, around 12:01, all the doors or the windows of that room, they were like, because of the air, there was no air, without air, and those doors and the windows were shaking, and they were like closing and opening again and again and making so much noise. So he was surprised that there is no air. Why it happened? He is a Brahman and intelligent also. He understood that there must be some ghost. So he himself was a very like a big person. So he held an iron stick in his hand. Like in earlier times, like to close the door, there was a big iron or a wooden stick used to be used to close the door. We have also seen in the past that nowadays, like they do not, no one uses that iron or the wooden stick to close the doors, but earlier the stick was used. So what he did, he was holding that iron stick that is used to close the door. So he shouted, "Who is there? Come in front of me." So So come in front of me. So that house was empty and there was no noise. And holding the stick in his hand, he was shouting that, come in front of me, who is here? These ghosts, they always come to a place where there is iron. So the Maharaj said that you are behaving like a monkey, that you are trying to scare me. But the ghosts, they are always scared of iron. So he was making this noise, the ghost, that I am a Brahmaditya, Brahma demon. So he spoke loudly and he also started laughing like this, so loudly. Aso, Sundar Gopal. So I am a Brahmaditya. So Maharaj said, where do you live? What is your name? So he said, that I am the leader of thousands of ghosts, group leader. Then Maharaj said, that what karma you have done in your previous life that you became Brahmaditya? Then he told his previous life story, that whatever he did in his previous life, because of that he has to become a demon, like a ghost. Then Maharaj said, do you want liberation from this ghost life? Then he started crying, yes, I want to get liberated from this body of ghost. So please liberate me. Then Maharaj said, that whatever ekadashis I have done, and if I have done one Nirjala Ekadashi, I am giving you the benefit of that Nirjala Ekadashi. So it is so surprising that just by saying this, Brahmaditya left that body of ghost and he got a transcendental body, and offering pranam to the Maharaj, he left. He disappeared. So it is written in the Shastra that if someone is on deathbed but is not getting died, so for that person, if you give the benefit of your one Nirjala Ekadashi, then that person would also get liberated. So this is the glories of Ekadashi. So Ekadashi is not an ordinary fast. So I also told another story one day. The story of Rukmangad and Dharmangad. Rukmangad went to Balkhilya Rishi and asking about his previous life, that what pious activities I have done in my previous life that I became king. Balkhilya Rishi said that you were a foolish in your previous life, you were a great sinner. You used to visit prostitutes so much. So he was surprised that how could I become king? So Balkhilya Rishi said that in the previous life you have done so many sins, but unintentionally you have followed one Nirjala Ekadashi fast. Because of that one Nirjala Ekadashi, your all sins were destroyed. That is why you became a king now. Rukmanga, he believed the Balkhandi Rishi and came back to the kingdom and announced that everyone has to follow the Ekadashi. That I have followed it unknowingly, but I got such a great benefit of keeping that Ekadashi. So it is a big story of Rukmangad. That I have become a king, I have got such a great opulence. So it is written in the Shastra that knowingly or unknowingly, if one follows the Ekadashi, so he gets great results. So the king Rukmangad, he announced in the whole kingdom that everyone has to follow Ekadashi. What happens on the first day of Ekadashi means the one day before, it is called Dashmi Tithi. On the day of Dashmi, the people of the servants of the king started announcing in the whole city that tomorrow is Ekadashi, everyone has to follow and no one should eat any type of grains. The one who is going to eat rice or wheat or dal, then he will be expelled from the kingdom and he will be given death penalty. So everyone out of fear started following Ekadashi. And after some days, Rukmangad, one day, he went to jungle for hunting. He went to a jungle and that deer whom he wanted to hunt that disappeared somewhere and he could not find the way to get out of the jungle. So when he entered into the deep forest, he saw a very beautiful girl, 17-18 years of age, and she is crying. And Rukmangad, he was attracted towards that girl and said that, "Who are you? Why are you crying?" She said that, "My parents have expelled me from their house and I am not married." So she was telling a fake story. So that is why I came here to suicide, to do suicide. Maharaj Rukmangad said that, "Why don't you marry me?" So she agreed and they exchanged the garlands in the jungle and got married. So now she is a queen. She came to the kingdom and she was welcomed by everyone. A great festival, great celebrations were done. And even the elder queen was welcoming. And Rukmangad's son, Dharmangad, he was very obedient son. So today is the Dashmi, the 10th day. And the announcement is there that tomorrow is Ekadashi, no one should accept eat the grains. But this new queen said, "I will eat everything on the day of Ekadashi, even if I do not eat it on other days. So I will eat everything, even egg. So on the day of Ekadashi, I will eat everything. I do not follow this Ekadashi." The sadhu sannyasis, the old people, should follow the Ekadashi. When the king came to know about it, Maharaj said, to the queen that this is a rule of our country that everyone has to follow Ekadashi. But she did not agree. After so much discussion, then the queen said, I will follow Ekadashi. But if the king Rukmangad and the elder queen, if they would cut the Dharmangad into two pieces and they should be laughing while cutting him into two pieces and not having tears in the eyes, then I will surely follow Ekadashi. Then Dharmangad, when he came to know about all this condition, he said that you should follow Dharma. Even if I die, but you should follow Dharma, because Dharma should be protected. He said that, O father, that you should fulfill the condition of that queen. And the mother of the Dharmangad also said, O king, whatever the younger queen is saying, we will surely do the same, but we will not leave Ekadashi. Everyone has to do Ekadashi. So on the decided time, everyone came to that place where he was to be cut off. So on the one side Rukmangad, and on the other side the mother of the Dharmangad was standing, and they were cutting. They were about to cut their son, and even the demigods came to see this incident. Even the Brahmaji appeared, Shivji appeared. That what kind of parents they are, that they are so ideal, that even they are going to cut their son just to protect the dharma. And the condition was that he should not be cut at once, he should be cut very slowly. That when they kept that weapon on the head of Dharmangad, then the Sakshat Bhagwan Vishnu appeared. So as soon as the Vishnu appeared, then that queen said, offering pranam to the Vishnu, said that, do not cut your son, I am not an ordinary lady, I am the Maya. I am Maya Devi. I have come here to test you, that your nishtha, what kind of nishtha you have towards Ekadashi. So then that Maya Devi disappeared, and Sakshat Bhagwan Vishnu Brahma Shiva, they all started blessing the king and also Dharmangad. So in any situation one should not leave Ekadashi. Many people, what they do, they follow Ekadashi then they also like after keeping fixed number of Ekadashis, like 11 Ekadashis, then they call a Brahman and do some kind of religious activity, and then after, like they say that this is my final Ekadashi, I will not keep Ekadashi after it. So they just keep the fixed number of Ekadashi. So this is also wrong system. So many people, even many pandits, they say that if you do not do the Udyapan means the final ceremony of the Ekadashi, then you will be died or something bad would happen. So this is all wrong concept, because Ekadashi is Sakshat Bhakti Savrupini. So Ekadashi should be followed. till the time your life is there, from the 8 years of age till the 80 years of age, everyone should follow Ekadashi. If your body is fine, you can keep Nirjala, you should keep Nirjala. And if your body is not good, then you should eat fruits. That is why it is said Anukalpa, means not Brihad Kalpa. Anukalpa means eating small, very less, even fruits only. But on the day of Ekadashi, one should never eat grains. If your body is good, then you should do Nirjala Ekadashi and also Nishi Jagran. That whole night, one should be awake and doing Kirtan, not awake killing the mosquitoes, only by chanting Harinam. One should be awake in the night of Ekadashi. So in this way, Mahaprabhu also used to do Naam Sankirtan on the Ekadashi night. Harikatha Shravan, one should also hear Harikatha. Also follow other limbs of the Ekadashi. Many people, they say that I have kept Nirjala today and I cannot chant Harinam. So this is not Ekadashi. Ekadashi is Upavas. Upa means near, Vas means to stay. To stay near Bhagavan. So how can one stay near Bhagavan? By chanting Lord's name or by hearing Harikatha. Upavas, upa means near, vas means to stay. So on the day of Ekadashi, one should chant Harinam and hear Harikatha. So one should always follow Ekadashi, reading scriptures, seeing the Vigraha, Parikrama, these kind of all bhakti limbs should be followed. In the Hari Bhakti Vilas, it is said there is a process of Ekadashi, to follow Ekadashi. Many people says that I will do only the Nirjala Ekadashi. They cannot get the results of the Ekadashi because they are not doing anything else about bhakti. Because Harinam is important. That one should always stay near Harinam, means chanting Harinam. So whatever number of rounds you are doing every day, on the day of Ekadashi, one should do more number of rounds. Like if you are doing 64 rounds every day, then on the day of Ekadashi, you do a little more. 2 or 4 or 6 rounds at least should be done more on the day of Ekadashi. There are many rules, but in the Kali Yuga it is not possible to follow all rules. But up to what extent you can follow, you should follow. But the main condition is one should not eat grains and one should always chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.